If you were briefing your former colleagues at the State Department or someone in the White House, what are the key takeaways from a policy perspective?
So if you look at the report actually has, I think, 8 or 9 specific policy recommendations. You know, A, emphasize the corporate sector. You know, do everything in your power to facilitate their working overseas, gain entry into other countries. That means what is going on today, you know, that means TTIP and TPP, you know, two big trade agreements. Everything should be behind those. And I think if I were to argue what is going to be President Obama's focus for the next 2 years, it's going to be TPP and TTIP for all sorts of reasons. Visa regime, we have to rethink our visa regime. I mean, we all know this. It's hugely politically controversial, but it has to be done. Understand that domestic policy is foreign policy as far as the Europeans are concerned. That means you actually have to have the Secretary of HHS talking to, or you know, DOJ talking to State Department and others. You have to recognize that at the moment there is this understanding of hypocrisy because people are watching. You can't anymore think of it entirely domestically. Follow through with one of the things that's already happening, which is focus hard power in Asia, soft power in Europe. Again, recognize that difference. So, I mean, there are some real policy changes, some of which are just concrete. We need to rethink our visa regime. Some of which are more nuanced. How do you express yourself? How do you define policies? I mean, one of the things that I always say from when I was at the NSC, I spent a vast amount of my time changing language. As somebody who is half American, half British, Americans will say, we are going to. Brits will say, we will try to. Actually, the Americans and the Brits mean exactly the same thing. We're going to put all of our efforts into doing X. The reality is they come across very, very differently. So, I mean, and I'm not talking about rhetoric. We need to follow rhetoric with action. There's a lot of critique in the Middle East. You know, President Obama did an absolutely fantastic speech in 2009. Does that make sense? In Egypt. And again, in our results, we heard, and the polls suggested as well, you know, great speech, where's the action? So, I mean, there are a number of changes, concrete changes that we can make, some of which are nuanced, some of which are more black and white.